NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has found the best evidence yet for emission from a neutron star at the site of a recently observed supernova. The supernova, known as SN1987A, was a core-collapse supernova, meaning the compacted remains at its core formed either a neutron star or a black hole. Evidence for such a compact object has long been sought, and while indirect evidence for the presence of a neutron star has previously been found, this is the first time that the effects of high-energy emission from the probable young neutron star have been detected. Supernova 1987A represents the remains of an exploded star that once had a mass around 8 to 10 times that of the Sun. It is located around 160,000 light-years away in the Large Magellanic Cloud, a dwarf galaxy neighbor of the Milky Way. Supernova 1987A was first spotted by astronomers 37 years ago in 1987, hence the numerical aspect of its name. As it exploded, supernova 1987A first showered Earth with ghostly particles called neutrinos and then became visible in bright light. This made it the nearest and brightest supernova seen in the night sky over Earth for around 400 years. About 2 hours prior to the first visible light observation of SN1987A, three observatories around the world detected a burst of neutrinos lasting only a few seconds. The two different types of observations were linked to the same supernova event, and provided important evidence to inform the theory of how core collapse supernovae take place. This theory included the expectation that this type of supernova would form a neutron star or a black hole. Indirect evidence for the presence of a neutron star at the center of the remnant has been found in the past few years, and observations of much older supernova remnants, such as the Crab Nebula, confirm that neutron stars are found in many supernova remnants. However, no direct evidence of a neutron star in the aftermath of SN1987A, or any other such recent supernova explosion, had been observed, until now. Astronomers have searched for evidence for one or the other of these compact objects at the center of the expanding remnant material ever since. The initial observation of SN1987A was preceded by a brief burst of neutrinos detected by three observatories, offering crucial corroborative evidence linking the neutrino burst and the subsequent supernova event. Supernova explosions such as this are responsible for seeding the cosmos with elements like carbon, oxygen, silicon, and iron. These elements ultimately become the building blocks of the next generation of stars and planets, and can even form molecules that may one day become integral to life as we know it. These explosions also birth compact stellar remnants either in the form of neutron stars or black holes. For 37 years, astronomers haven't known which of these may lurk at the heart of supernova 1987A. Spectral analysis of the results showed a strong signal due to ionized argon from the center of the ejected material that surrounds the original site of SN1987A. Subsequent observations using Webb's NIRSpec, near-infrared spectrograph, IFU at shorter wavelengths found even more heavily ionized chemical elements, particularly 5x ionized argon, meaning argon atoms that have lost 5 of their 18 electrons. Such ions require highly energetic photons to form, and those photons have to come from somewhere. The newly identified neutron star had avoided detection for 37 years due to the fact that, as a newborn, it was still surrounded by a thick shroud of gas and dust launched during the supernova blast that signaled the death throes of its progenitor star. Detection has been hindered by the fact that the supernova condensed about half a solar mass of dust in the ensuing years after the explosion, Barlow said. This dust acted as a screen obscuring radiant from the center of supernova 1987A. The dust is far less effective at blocking infrared light than it is at blocking visible light. So, to see through this death shroud and into the heart of supernova 1987A, Barlow and colleagues turned to the highly sensitive infrared eye of the JWST, particularly the telescope's mid-infrared instrument and near-infrared spectrograph. The smoking gun evidence for this hidden neutron star had to do with emissions from the elements argon and sulfur coming from the center of supernova 1987A. These elements are ionized, meaning they have had electrons stripped from their atoms. Barlow said that this ionization could have only occurred due to radiation emitted by a neutron star. The emissions enabled the team to put a limit on the brightness or luminosity of the once-hidden neutron star. They determined it to be around a tenth of the brightness of the Sun. The team may have determined that a neutron star was birthed by supernova 1987A, but not all the mysteries of this neutron star are solved yet. That's because the ionization of argon and sulfur that served as their smoking gun could have been caused by a neutron star in one of two ways. Winds of charged particles dragged along and accelerated to near light speed by a rapidly rotating neutron star could have interacted with surrounding supernova material, causing the ionization. Or, ultraviolet and X-ray light emitted by the million-degree surface of the hot neutron star could have stripped electrons away from atoms at the heart of this stellar wreckage. Supernovae, the explosive final death throes of some massive stars, blast out within hours, and the brightness of the explosion peaks within a few months. The remains of the exploding star will continue to evolve at a rapid rate over the following decades, offering a rare opportunity for astronomers to study a key astronomical process in real time. How does a neutron star hide for four decades? Neutron stars are born when massive stars exhaust their fuel supplies needed for nuclear fusion happening at their cores. This cuts off the outward energy flowing from these stars' cores that protects them from collapsing under their own gravity. As a stellar core collapses, tremendous supernova explosions rip through the star's outer layers, blasting them away. This leaves behind a dead star as wide as the average city here on Earth, but with a mass around one or two times that of the Sun, the star ends up composed of a fluid of neutron particles, which is the densest known matter in the universe. More observations are planned this year, with Webb and ground-based telescopes. The research team hopes ongoing study will provide more clarity about exactly what is happening in the heart of the SN1987A remnant. These observations will hopefully stimulate the development of more detailed models, ultimately enabling astronomers to better understand not just SN1987A, but all core collapse supernovae. These findings were published in the journal Science.